Dementia is a gradual breakdown of memory, thought, and behavior. What we do is discover equations that predict how dementia works in the mind, such as how fast does it spread and where. We start by making a map of how brain regions are connected to each other by white matter pathways. This map is called a connectome. Each region is a cluster of neurons that together serve a distinct functional role. For instance, we can define one region as the hippocampus, which is important for memory formation. Normally, there are proteins called tau proteins that are responsible for maintaining the structure of neurons. However, due to reasons such as broken protein repair systems, tau proteins can become misfolded and damage white matter pathways instead of fixing them. It's been found that in dementia, there's a vast amount of misfolded tau proteins which spread throughout the brain. So, to understand how the brain's connections are affected under dementia, we need to measure how connected it remains before and after the condition progresses. So, how do we find these equations? First, let's model the brain's connectome as a graph, which consists of nodes that are connected by edges. The nodes are connectome areas, while the edges are structural or functional connections between them. In our case, we're modeling these connections as white matter pathways, which transmit signals. Our goal here is to figure out how connected each region is to each other, and to summarize this connectedness as a number that we can use to determine how badly dementia has wrecked the brain's connectivity. How do we calculate this? By using a collection of numbers called the Graph Laplacian matrix. Each row in the matrix corresponds to a node, and so does each column. This is made up of just two terms, D minus A. D is the degree matrix, and for each node, it contains the degree of that node. That is, how many neighbors that node has. A is the adjacency matrix, such that for each pair of nodes, there's a 1 if there's an edge between them, and a 0 if there's no edge between them. The values for these matrices are based on real-world pathway data, measured by medical instruments. Finally, the graph Laplacian is just L equals D minus A. Why use this definition to measure connectivity? We can answer that by applying L on a graph of values. Let F be a function that assigns a value to each node. We can view F as a vector, such that each value is a component in a vector. F can be values, like the amount of white matter in a region, or how much tau has accumulated in a region, while L captures a node's connectivity. Given that L is a matrix, and F is a vector, we can perform matrix vector multiplication using L times F. We just take each row of L and multiply each element in that row by its corresponding element in F. This outputs a value in the vector LF. Let's rewrite LF as DF minus AF. Let's look at a single row, or node, of LF. We'll perform an operation for matrix multiplication on it. If we describe what this math represents, we see that in the first term, it's multiplying the value of a node with its own degree, and in the second term, it's subtracting the sum of its neighbor's values. The reason why we're multiplying the node by its degree is because we're replicating the node's value once for each of its edges, so we can compare edge by edge. The more similar a node is to the sum of its neighbors, the lower the value of LF is for that node. The less similar a node is, the higher this value. That's how we describe the similarity for a single node. What about summarizing how similar a graph's nodes are to each other overall? We can add up the differences for every component in LF, weighing each component's difference by its assigned value in F, which means nodes with larger values more strongly influence the summarized value. This gives us a single number that captures the global similarity of a graph. Formally, we'll do this by multiplying F as a row by LF. If we rearrange FLF, we obtain the following equation that calculates square differences, so the sign doesn't matter. We call this value the smoothness of a graph. Smoothness is the overall similarity or variation across nodes in a graph. When nodes are more similar in value, the graph is smoother. And when they're more different, the graph is rougher. One reason why it's called this is because when you're feeling how smooth a surface is, you don't just put your finger on one point of it, but you brush your hands across the surface. We can use smoothness to tell the overall differences in graph structure between two graphs. We just explained how to use the graph Laplacian to describe how connected a mind remains after it's torn by dementia. Next time, we'll use analogies to explain why we use eigenvectors to measure these connectivities with a single value. For the full explanation, check out this video.